we review some classical combinatorial optimization problems and show how they can be modeled into mixed integer linear problems. In this video, we introduce the set covering problem. After the World Cup in Russia, Camille wants to complete her collection of stickers, and she can buy collections of stickers from her schoolmates. In each available collection, there are stickers that she needs, but also stickers that she does not need. However, the schoolmates do not accept to sell stickers individually. She must buy the whole collection or nothing. Camille must decide which collections to purchase in order to complete her own album at a minimum price. This is an example of a set covering problem. So to provide a more general definition, we have a set U of M elements. In this case, these were the stickers. And we have N subsets of these elements. These are the collections of the schoolmates. And for each element J, I know if it belongs to subset Si or not. This is characterized by the data Aij. It's equal to 1 if element J belongs to subset Si and 0 otherwise. Each of the subsets is associated with a cost. In that case, it would be the cost that Camille would have to pay to purchase the collection from the schoolmate. The objective is to choose capital J subsets of minimal cost such that we have access to all the elements in U, so that the union for J equals 1 to capital J of S ij is equal to U. So we need to cover the universe using the subsets. It's a set covering problem. In order to model it as a mixed integer linear problem, well, we need to do three things: to define the decision variables, to define the objective function, and to define the constraints. Here, we will assign a decision variable to each subset I, and this will be a binary variable that is 1 if the subset is selected and 0 otherwise. The objective function consists in minimizing the total cost, which is the sum over all possible subsets, Ci, Xi. And now we need to make sure that each element in U is made available. So for any J in U, we need to make sure that it is available. And it can be available from any subset that has been selected. So to know if it is available or not, we need to look at the sum over all subsets of Aij, Xi. Here we have a case where we model a conjunction. In order to have access to item J from collection I, two things need to be verified. J must be in I. This is modeled by this A constant here. And I need to decide to buy I. And the product represents the conjunction, the logical conjunction. And this must be greater or equal to 1. I need at least once item J. If I have it more than 1, it's okay, but I need it at least once. And then, of course, the variables must be binary. As you can see, this is a binary linear problem. All the variables are binary. The objective function is linear, and the constraints are linear as well. The set covering problem is also a classical combinatorial optimization problem relevant in many contexts, such as personnel shift planning, for example. And we have seen in this video that it can be modeled as a mixed integer linear problem. Actually, it was a binary linear problem in this case.